This is the cab for my 94 F-250. It's from Arizona, there's no rust on it. I just finished undercoating
whole underside.
Rockers, cab mounts, the whole floor has been done.
Painted this spot
yesterday with self-etch. It was in a fire. Cruise control sits right up about in here somewhere, and that caught on fire. Burned all the electrical, but we're throwing my diesel dash in it, so it didn't really matter. There's a few dings on each side next to the mirrors. I'm working on fixing those right now. It had those big like tripod mirrors on it before, so I'm gonna be deleting those. And I gotta fill those holes in from that. When the guy lifted it up, he didn't want to wait till we got there and messed up the door and the top of the cab on both sides. So we have to fix that. This side's a little bit worse. So that kind of pissed me off, because other than those spots in the mirror, it's like one spot right there, there was nothing wrong with this cab. So we didn't have to do a lot of body work to it until he messed that up. So I got everything undercoated. I'm going to be doing the same to the bottom of the bed. I'm not planning on driving this truck in the winter, but we do have a lot of moisture up here, and it still rusts stuff up pretty bad, so I don't want to put all this money into it and have it rusting again, so.
Yeah, I got this new cab, a bed, tailgate, fenders, radiator support.
Pretty much all the body panels are new hood. New Ford parts from out of state that are rust free. Didn't want to put any aftermarket parts on this just because they don't fit very well and they're kind of cheap.
So this is pretty much a frame-off restoration on it.
I got the hood over here for the 61, I believe, red face. We got this thing running the other day. So we put a new head gasket on it. Run it a little bit and change the oil, and then we're gonna paint it. So I'm gonna be painting this same color as this welder over here. It's a metallic silver. Little update on my F-250 project.
Alright, so I got all the dents fixed in this thing. Got that roof fixed.
I don't know if I showed this in the last video, but it's all undercoated. Yeah, so I just finished undercoating the fenders. Just on any of the parts that are going to get hit by stones. And then I did on the inside lip as well. So I'm going to be sanding the cab down, scuffing it, and then that should be ready for paint here in the next day or two. We got that door all blocked out. This one I still got to spray and black out. I kind of wanted to wait till I could get my mirrors because the aftermarket ones that I got were pretty much garbage. They don't fit. They're not anywhere close to the same size as the other ones. They don't look similar at all, so I gotta try to find some Ford ones at the junkyard or something. So I kind of wanted to wait, get those all marked out and holes drilled, because these holes from the old mirrors have to be filled now, welded and
filled, so that'll have to be primed and blocked again.
But I'm pretty happy with the way everything turned out. Had those big tow mirrors on it before. And I'm going with the smaller tow mirrors like what's on my truck. So I got the holes welded and filled down there and all blocked out. So sand the fenders and get those doors finished, and want to paint all that stuff at the same time. And once I get all that painted, I'll hang the doors back on the cab. Probably just throw the fenders up on there to keep them from getting scratched up right now on the ground once they're painted. And then there's a couple dents on the bed, nothing major that I gotta fix. The main thing on that is it was up in Arizona and all the paint's peeling off the sides of them, so I gotta sand all that down. And then that will be ready for paint, and then I got spray and bed liner that I'm gonna put in that. So those are some videos of the painting of the truck and bed liner and all that.
I'm pretty happy with the way this undercoating turned out. Don't want to go all this time and money
into this thing and then have a bunch of stone chips all over along the bottom of it and start rusting.
We live in Michigan,
so everything, it doesn't matter if you don't drive the vehicle in the winter time, it still starts to get rusty. So I'm doing everything I can to prevent that.